considered a great privilege to be your vice cardinal. For this, I am grateful first to our Lord Jesus Christ, because it is only by His grace that I was able to go through my first term. Of course, I would like to thank my family for their love and support. Thank you, Enzo, Leo, Manny, and my eldest, the whole Martin, who is also our young mother. Thank you, too, to my governor, Matthew Marcus Amado, for your trust, and I vow to continue to support you, especially in the legislature, in the Assembly and the Thank you, too, to my senadora, Amy Marcos, also known as the Dakilang Padre Presidente. Thank you for your guidance and your support always. And to our congressman of the 2nd District, Angelo Marcos Barba, thank you for all your advice you give me, as it truly has helped me navigate being the presiding officer. And to our UPN Unlock, Congressman Sandro Marcos. Ang ganda ng pakinggan. I know you have prepared yourself for the task at hand, and we are here to support you in every way. Your success is the province's success. And to all my Nataraki, ang vocals, and the known na pintas na vocala, thank you so much for your patience with me. I would also like to include thank you to all the mayors and vice mayors and all the councilors, especially those that have been so supportive in the staging of the Mercado de la Naisas in the different municipios and cities. May I continue to count on your support on our future endeavors. And I would like to acknowledge my family from San Juanga, friends from Davao, and Manila. Thank you. Here to show your support. Thank you. As I look back on the term that was, I am filled with mixed emotions, mainly because I remember how I was thrust into this arena. As all of you know, it was because of the demise of the love of my life, Mariana Bobby Marcos. It is bittersweet because this position was for you. But in his passing, I have come to embrace you all in my heart. To borrow the words of our ever beautiful Madame First Lady, Imelda Ramon Valdez Marcos, who was very instrumental in my desire to take this challenge. She said, "I am an Unitano by choice, and now so am I." It is to you, my Kailians, that I choose to serve and to love. The past 3 years gave us the worst of times and the best of times, because this pandemic made us so fearful of what lies ahead. And the best of times because we saw how resilient we are in the face of adversity. I am just so glad that our leaders were there for such a time. I would like to recognize our outgoing resident, Rodrigo Roman Duterte, as he took decisive steps during the pandemic. Thank you for all you have done for our country. I most especially want to recognize our dear governor, Governor Matthew Marcos Cavite, for his dynamism and his decisiveness as he boldly took the helm, often making decisions that may not have been popular, but was necessary for us to really get the situation at hand in control. Despite some bashing, he was able to make us obey protocols and his executive orders. That is a true mark of a leader. Due to his decisiveness, we have ranked number one the region and number three in the whole Philippines for our vaccination rollout. I believe he deserves a resounding round of applause for his stellar performance in this giant. Thank you so much, Governor. Which brings me to the exciting scenario ahead, having our president, Juan Paul Marcos, again, ang sarap sabihin, ang sarap pakinggan, President Juan Paul Marcos. We have a great leader as our head, then we have our ever beautiful, intelligent, creative, lahat na, in our Senator Raayo. Then we have two, not one, but two congressmen in the province. One with the wisdom and experience in the person of Congressman Angelo Marcos Barba. And our enthusiastic, passionate congressman of the 1st District, Congressman Santo Marcos. Then we have our deliberate and dynamic Governor Manuel Marcos in the executive, and yours truly, Vice Governor in the legislative, along with our youthful Sangguniang. With this combination, I just know that Ilocos Norte will truly be a bustling province full of potential with great opportunities for our candidates. To borrow the words of our beloved President Bongbong Marcos, sama sama tayo papa. And this connotes that we all have a part to do, not just us government officials, but each of us may be all supportive, participative, and most especially obedient to our laws, then truly babangon tayo and proudly say, ako ay pilipino. At kamana